Dr. John Rossini. I have to say, these guys were actually really well prepared from the first rehearsal that we went in with them on, and they're playing incredibly well already, and there's a little hum on stage. Thank you. So what I wanted to say is that part of that is youth. Part of that energy is youth. I played with a lot of orchestras throughout Europe in different places, and you don't get this type of energy in a piece like this. So I just want to say thank you. The show is a combination of two kind of symphonic pieces. One is Orca, which you heard the first act of, which I'll talk about later. And the rest is the Lekkedet Symphony series, which are songs that I've been singing along with. This song's called Phoenix.
Thank you.
separating, differentiating us beyond our cultures, beyond our beliefs. Borders are subjective, unnatural lines drawn by humans, delineating land, water, and air for partisan collective utilization. If borders were natural, all beings, other animals, would be bound by them as well. Indigenous cultures never recognize borders, cognizant of the fact that the land owns us and not the other way around. Borders lead to war, occupation, bigotry, even genocide. Worst of all, borders are a deceptive and constant reinforcement of the notion that we are alone, separate from each other and all things around us. Multi-layered borders of our lives stratify separations in their undignified definitions. There are people dying in Kashmir every day due to water dispute. Shots are fired daily between North and South Korea. Burning walls separate German people for half a century. Israel and Palestine continue in their conflict. The Ottoman Turks now tell they have to carry out genocide to protect their borders. Their borders. Their borders. Their borders. Their motherfucking borders. Of civilization, expansionism, abuse of capitalism, and presumptuous occupation. Floods don't recognize borders. Earthquakes, disease, famine, droughts don't recognize borders.